Hi everyone, so today we will be discussing about how to monitor process level metrics. In my previous videos I have explained you how to monitor host level metrics like Windows host machine, what kind of metrics we have to monitor, and Unix host level, what kind of monitors you have to monitor. Please go and watch my previous videos if you need further details before watching this. So we'll be monitoring two kinds of metrics, right? One is host level metrics and other one is process level metrics. So I have created one small application in Spring Boot. So to run that application, so administration service, so I have some data. So I am going to show you guys today this one. I have deployed in Tomcat server. So today we'll see how to monitor using some other tools. So today we'll be discussing about JConsole. So already my application is running. If you see here, this is already running. If you enable here, see already this hospital iPhone administration service is already up and it is running on 8081 port. And also we can test that this is simple web services application. We just have static data. One is retrieving patients and other one is retrieving patient by ID. See, if you see here, so we have two calls by patients and retrieve patients by ID. So these are the two calls. We are just get methods, they are nothing. So before that we will go and see the J. So you have few free tools where you can monitor heap memory, threads, and other things like process host utilization, those things. So there are two tools. One is JVisual VM, which comes with until 1.8 it used to come with Java JDK. After 1.9 they are not providing JVisual VM with Java alone. You have to download them separately. So I can show you how to download to monitor any process level metric. And I am going to program files, but we have this one. I am having JDK 11 version. Go to bin. Under bin we can see JConsole. So search for J. So here we have right JConsole. Just click this one. You will see one window. So let it open. See, it is showing, it is telling you that Java monitoring and management console. So here I have few applications which are already running. So my application is this one, .com Venkat Hospital administration application. So I am going to run this one. If you want to monitor, this is my local process. If in your case, if you want to monitor your application, you can monitor that host name slash. They will give you JMX port. You can provide that JMX port and your username password. If you click connect, you will be able to monitor it. In my case, I am running my application in local. So my local process I will select. Okay. Just click on connect. So it will give you one error. Click on insecure connection because this is just local host. Yeah, so this is my application. If you see here, overview. Heap memory usage, currently used memory is 42 MB. So as soon as application runs, it is using by default this much memory. And committed memory means available memory. Max it can go until 146 MB and max it can go 1.6 GB. So that is what it is saying. And how many classes it's been loaded and how many threads currently are there. So currently without running anything there are 48 threads are there. We will see those details. And CPU utilization, if you see, it is very less, utilizing 0.01%. so this is all about process level metrics, threads, classes, and CPU. This is only process level. Host level metrics, you know, right, how to monitor. Either you can go and check here as well, right? You can right click here, task manager. So whatever you see here, these are all process level metrics under performance. If you see here, these are all host level metrics. CPU currently, see, they utilizing around 70%, 80% like that, and memory, disk. These and all are processors, host level metrics. These are all process level metrics. If you want to see more memory level, these are the metrics. Okay, I will come to this part later. Just I am showing you high level. These are threads. So currently, if you see, my port is 8081, right? As I mentioned here, my application is running on port 8081. So it will create some thread, default threads. So there are currently there are 46 live threads. These peak threads are nothing but daemon threads which are running background. So we no need to worry much about this one. We are always worrying about live threads. So if you see here, this 8081, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there are total 12 are running. Okay. So as soon as we start test, we can see more live threads. Okay. So classes also, we have seen how many classes currently loaded. 9582 classes are loaded. Okay. So this is JVM summary. Like what is we have garbage collection algorithms, right? So by from 1.9 onwards, we are using G1 garbage collection algorithm. Before 1.8, parallel GC is algorithm which is automatically coming, but 9.1 onward, G1 will be the our default garbage collection. Until unless you change it manually through command prompt, it won't change. Okay, by default it will be the GC algorithm. These and all details like how many live threads, peak daemon threads, total threads, how many are there, what is the operating system, and this and all our this is mbeans. We can see what is the details like all memory details, global memory, all this kind of details, but we are not much worried about this one. Okay, the only main thing we are worrying is now memory threads and CPU, host level CPU, process utilization. Okay, so currently we are seeing very less. See, if you see, even live threads are very less, 46. Even heap memory also steadily maintaining at 50, and there is no major activity. If you see at major memory, so this is old collections, GC collections, 1469 collections. So let me do one thing. I will stop my server and I will start it. We can get freshly. Okay, so let me go to my services. Okay, let me stop this admin services. Whenever I stop it, it will create new process. This also will get stopped. Okay. And also let me stop my discovery server as well. And if you see here, see, connection failed because the JVM shutdown, all heap memory, everything came to zero. Whenever you shut down your application, it will go to zero, right? Where all memory will get released. So say cancel and just close this one. Here, see, now nothing is showing, only two applications are showing. One is J console, the other one is Spring Boot. That is this one. These two processes are running. As soon as I start my services, you can see them there. Now I will start first discovery server. So as soon as discovery server starts, we can see one more process here with the new process ID. So it is taking time to load. Yeah, it is loading now. Yeah, it is starting now. So the JMX is starting. See, it is initializing all the details. See, updating port number, started discovery server. Now you can go and see, there will be one more server. Still it did not come. Okay, so let's start our another server as well. application, hospital management. Okay, sometimes it won't come, so in that case what we have to do is go to connection, new connection. See, now we are seeing that discovery is server 1 and even hospital 1 also it came. Okay, Venkat hospital administration application, so this is the one, right? Hospital administration, here also you can see that is the one which is opening. Okay, so now both the ports are up, so let's go click on connect. Just click on insecure mode. Yeah, see, now everything is empty. As soon as application starts, you can see how much MB it is utilizing. Okay, so classes loaded and live count, I think it is not that good. We can keep this way only, it looks little better. You can see everything here, see, used memory and classes and how many live threads, usage. So as soon as application loads, it will load everything, right? So that is the reason you will see little high memory on everywhere. Later it will come to very less. If you see now heap memory also, it came to very less, it become 28. Okay, classes loaded 9000. Let's go to memory, we are more concentrated here. See, if you see garbage collections, there are only 11 collections as of now because nothing is running, so there is no major collection is happening, right? Garbage collection. So in garbage collection, you know, right, most of them might be knowing or might not be knowing. In heap memory, we'll be having three generations. One is hidden generation, that is called as young generation. The other one is old generation. The other one is survivor space. So whenever hidden space is full, then it will do garbage collection. Then those whoever survived, those goes to survivor space. Then again GC will happen, again they will go to survivor space. Survivor space will be very less, it will be 10 MB or 12 MB or 50 MB, depends on application. Once that is full, they will move to old generation. Old generation, you will see major full GC. Okay, here you can see old generation garbage collection and young generation garbage collection. Young generation is nothing but hidden generation. Whatever hidden space we will say, that is young generation. Whatever old generation we will say, that is this one. This is non-heap area where we will call it as meta space. From 1.9 onwards, previously it is called as a term generation, where classes, methods, everything will be loaded here. See, meta space, right? So this is all about high level about heap memory, non-heap memory. Coming to threads, each application will be having some threads. See, starting of the application there were 52, now they become 45. You can see all these 801s are the ones which are related to our application. See, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12, total 12 are running. Okay, so as soon as we see the application running, then we can see the increase on the live count, memory, okay, everything. Okay, so let me show you the application, how it looks like in UI. Same thing, I have designed the scenario by adding one by patient by ID and other one is get patient details. So you can go here, localhost administration, just click on patients, you will get all list of patient details. See, so I have around 18 to 20 patient details. And if you want patient ID by ID, I have done correlation for this one. Automatically randomly it will pick some of the patient ID and it will click enter. So it will give only that particular patient ID. What is patient name, nationality, what is his ID. Just very simple static data. I did not use dynamically. I just created one static data to show you guys how JVM works. What is JVM, heap memory, most of the interviews they will be asking, right? What kind of tools you are using. You can tell this is one of the tool. If you don't have any monitoring profiling tools, this is one inbuilt tool which comes with JDK, which will be available under bin folder under JDK. J console dot exe. So if you have local applications, you can see local application. Otherwise, let's go. Let me go again here. See if it is local process, you can see them here. If it is remote process, you have to enter the IP address, host name, and port number, JMX port number, and username password. In my case, mine is a local application, so I am selecting that one and I am clicking on connect. Okay, so that is only one difference. Okay, so now again let's wait for some time. We'll see all these things will be settled down, then we will start our application. Meanwhile, I will make sure I opened all my scenario is ready and everything is ready. If you see my scenario, I have created little step download, no ramp up, slow ramp up things. First I am running with 20 users for 5 minutes, then again I am adding another 20 users, again I am doing 5 minutes test, and again I am adding 10 more users, and I am running for another 5 minutes. Okay, just slow ramp up with slow steady state users. Okay, like, no, to identify the how the application is behaving. Okay, to know more details. Okay, so let's go ahead and start the test now. Okay, so click on start test. I am not worrying where to save results because it is just simple application. So now my application is starting, and you can see our garbage collection utilizing more memory and all. Okay, see, it is at 25 GB, and now it will slowly increases. Okay, see, even process level also you can see it all of a sudden from 0 to 30 MB, it went 30% process level it went. Okay, if you see here GC started. Okay, so memory also it is keep on running. If you go to memory, you can see more details. See, already even the garbage collection also started, 21% 22 garbage collections. It took only 320 milliseconds. Always young generation will have very less freshly created objects, so it will take less time. Okay, in old generation it took clear all the long running objects, it will take lot of time, but young generation it will be always less. See, all our objects 28-30 collections, the collections will be, now onwards it will be keep on increasing, because it will be keep on doing parallel garbage collection. As soon as it reaches max, it starts doing all garbage collection. Okay, so even you can perform GC also. If you want to run manually, you can click on perform GC, automatically it will run GC for you. But here we no need to run any GC, we just see. If you want to see overview, just this is good idea. See, even our live threads also little bit increasing, not too many, but there are 3 to 4 threads got increased. Okay, now there are 20 users are running in my application. The response times also you can see they are very very less. See, 0.0 seconds, milliseconds. Sometimes it took high, but remaining all times it is very simple application, right? So see, my threads from here onwards it will be steady, because I am running with 10 users, so 20 users it should be steady state. If you see, you can see more up and downs, right, in my application memory. That means whenever GC happens, the memory usage comes down. Whenever memory goes up, there is no GC collection. Whenever you see one GC, that means your memory will be coming down. Okay, so that is more about this one. If you want to know more details, click on this one. Automatically it will move to hidden space. You can see what is the hidden space memory. Currently hidden space is utilizing at 70 MB. Okay, and max is this one, and you can see how many GCs are happening at hidden memory. Okay, and even you can see old generation also. In old generation also, currently the heap memory is utilizing at 25 MB. okay, this also you can see linear increase whenever the application is running. That we can see after some time, let it run. And this is server space. As I mentioned, it is very less MB. It is maximum of 10 1024 KB means 1 MB is utilizing. Okay, so very less utilization, right? Because not major garbage collections, so there will be less object. In my application there are only two objects, one is list and other one is just getting the data. Okay, so that is the reason. So and you can see even non heap memory meta space also how many classes are loaded. So it is static. Once the application started, the classes, there are no more classes are loading. It is constantly staying there only. Even you can see this one code heap non n methods. This is m methods. In how many methods are loaded? Okay. So this is also compressed class space. How much classes are loaded? So these are all related to class related. How many classes? How many methods loading in the memory? Static memory. Okay. So this is called non-heap memory. We'll call it as static memory or meta space. So this is heap memory, this is meta space. So heap memory, if you see min and max, they will be assigning, right? That will be this one. If you go here, you can see what will be the min memory and max memory it is utilizing. If you see, there will be one max memory also. Those details you can find here. If you come here, current heap size, maximum how much memory, 1.5 GB it is there. Okay, so how much time it is spent on garbage collection, G1 garbage collection. Okay, so in some of the interview they may ask you from 1.9 onwards what is the default garbage collection algorithm, that is G1. In previous 1.8 until 1.8 parallel GC is the default one. Okay, and also 1.9 onwards we have metaspace. Previously it is called as permanent generation. Okay, permgen. See, if you see here, lot of GC is happening, right? That you can see more spikes going up and coming down. Okay, that means, see here, you can see more details. Used memory, committed memory means this much memory is available to store the Java objects. Still it can go until this one. Okay, then if it is still going, it will go maximum of 1.6 GB for this application. Okay, so classes, there are no change in the classes. Whatever classes it is loaded, as soon as the application starts, it is staying at the same place. If you come to threads, we can see little change here. Let me go to threads. See, starting there were some threads, then they came down. When we start the application, we increase some, we see some of the thread count increases. Okay, now we go and see, when we started there were 12 threads were there, right? Now we can go and see how many threads are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. See, 13, 1 got increased. Okay, see, here also few more got created. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. See, now they become 17 threads. Okay, as soon as users increases, it is also increasing the thread size also. By default, all application servers, they will be having pool size, thread pool size as default 40 or 50 thread pool size. Until it goes that thread pool size, it will keep on running. If you keep on increasing your users, and finally it will reach your thread pool size max, and you will see more CPU utilization. It will reach 100%, and you will see all 503 errors, because whatever request you are sending, it won't be able to give the response in time. So that is the reason. See, the threads are keep on increasing. See, there is one more thread that is got created, because you see little increase here, so it is getting increasing. Okay, so this is the way we can monitor. Whenever you see thread HTTP, this number, this is your port number. In my case, the port number of my application is 8081. You can see that thread number. In real time, you may not see this same way. It will be different number. Okay. So that way you can identify what are the real threads you want to monitor. The main threads you want to monitor is this port related threads, which are, if you see here, few are runnable state, that means they are running currently. This is waiting for this lock to be released. Timed waiting, you can see three types of statuses: timed waiting, waiting and running. Timed waiting doesn't matter, it will wait for only few times. As soon as it gets chance, it will get executed. You should not see waiting. Waiting means it is waiting for something to be released, or that process might be waiting for some other process to join. Okay, so you should not see more waiting threads. You can see only either runnable or timed waiting. Okay, that is good. If you see runnable and waiting means, runnable means you are right, it is running thread. Waiting thread means it is waiting for timed waiting. Okay, it is waiting for something to complete. Okay, see again few, sometimes that status also changes. As soon as you go and come up, some threads will go to timed waiting, some will go to executing mode. Okay, so runnable, timed waiting and waiting. Even some interview they may ask you what are the thread statuses you will see in thread dumps. Here you don't have ability to take thread dumps, but here it is saying detect thread lock, deadlocks. If you click on deadlocks, it will show you no deadlocks. If you see here, it will be blocked, state will be blocked. So let me summarize here in the notepad. So threads states, so one is runnable, timed waiting, waiting, timed waiting and waiting. Waiting means it will be waiting for something. Okay, so and other one is blocked. Blocked means you should not see deadlocks. Blocked means that is due to deadlocks, because the other thread also trying to get the same data, this thread also going to get same data. So now the thread is blocked because both are trying to get same data, and this is depending on that one, that is depending on this one, so they will be blocked. Okay, so these are the main thread states. Okay, even heap memory also you will have young gen, old gen and perm gen. This is until 1.8 version Java 1.8. okay, until Java 1.8 they will call it as perm generation. Okay, later it become metaspace. Okay, metaspace from 1.java 1.9 onwards it will be metaspace. Okay, these are the heap. Then GC, garbage collection, also we have algorithms, GC algorithms. Okay, I know few algorithms, you can search in Google. I can tell you whatever I am remembering now. Okay, so parallel GC, parallel GC, the other one is MKC, CMC, concurrent mark sweep GC. The other one is G1 is from 1.9 Java 1.9 onwards, this is new one. new GC algorithm with default. This will be the default GC. If some interviewer asks what is the default GC in 1.9 onwards, G1 GC. Until 1.8, Java 1.8, parallel GC is the default one. Until 1.8, right? Okay. Until 1.8, okay. Default. Okay. So these are the GCs. There are few more GCs are available. Just go and search in Google. Let me go and search for you. GC algorithms. Algorithm Java 8, 9. Okay, so just give Java 9. Okay, you'll get more idea. So there are some few more sites where you can go and search Java algorithms. Okay, you'll get a fair idea what is Java GC algorithm. Some interview they will ask you. So see mark and sweep. Okay. GC implementation, yeah, these are the JVMs, four types of GC implementations. As I mentioned, parallel GC, I missed this one. Okay, serial GC also. Okay, serial GC, parallel GC, this is default. The other one is CMS, the other one is GC. So G1 GC is 1.9. we have more details here. Okay, I will give you this one in my description also. You can look for more details on this one. If you want, you can read. Okay. So serial GC is good for when you have single processor. Parallel GC is good for when you have multi-core processors, right? I have four-core processor. And CMS GC is also some kind of usage. And G1 also some kind of usage. Okay. These are the GCs you have. In interviews they will ask you in your application which GC they are using. Okay, so you can see them under here. Where is that? Okay, under VM summary you can see what GC you are using. Garbage collector, you can see what GC they are using. Okay, so this way you can tell them what is GC. And so you got, I think you got something right. What is garbage collection, how threads, what are the thread types. Okay, so these are the thread types. And we have process CPU utilization also. Okay, and process CPU, and we have JDBC connection pooling as well. JDBC connections. We have database connection, then you will have JDBC connection pooling. You will see lot of data, users will go and update in database. Okay, I will try to create one more application later. I don't know when I am going to create. That time I can show you what is JDBC connections also. For now I am only showing these details. Okay, so let's see how my application is going. So it's done. Okay, the application is done, it seems. Okay, now we go and see how the application went. See, if you see here, you'll see lot of GCs, right? Parallel is going up and down. When you see here, after the application stops, the GC is not going that much. It is very slowly. There is no big spike up and downs. It is going slowly, little up and coming down. Okay, like this you can see. Even threads also, they might be coming down. See, there were around 90 threads during this time. Later it came to 46. As soon as application completes, again it came to a normal 12. We had 12, right? The same 12 will be coming here. Okay, so we can see here 1 2 3 4 5. six seven eight 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, by default 12 threads will be created for this application. As soon as application users increases, it will be expanded, the new threads will be created. So as soon as test is completed, the threads also came down to normal. By default any application, there will be some default threads will be created, because as soon as you start the application, these threads will be utilized. Okay, see, if you see here, see this, you should not see waiting means it is completely waiting for something. You should see always stand waiting. Okay, and you should not see even blocking threads. In most of them should be timed waiting is fine. You should not see more waiting threads. Okay, that means it is waiting for something. It will take longer times. Even it will get released sometime, but it will take some time. Even you can see where it is waiting for. It is waiting for object to come down. What object? So you can see more details. So here there is only one drawback with this J console is you cannot take thread dumps and heap dumps to analyze. Okay, so thread dumps and heap dumps are very good to know, like if there are more threads are utilizing, you want to see what is going on in our application, then you can take thread dumps. And memory dumps, if you see more GC issues, you can take this ones. Okay, if you see even this memory also, old generation also slowly increasing, right? Yeah, so likewise you can see more increase in the thread this application as well. Okay, so old generation, and you can see even survivor's phase. See, starting it was 1 MB, in between it went 1, 2 MB, 3 MB, then again it came to normal to 1 MB. Even you can see class loading will be always static. There is not too much class loadings. Okay, and methods, they may be increasing, but other than that it should be straightforward. Okay, so those are all, you can see how many classes loaded and everything here. So this is overview. And process level also, see, if you see here CPU, it was utilizing around 30 to 40% during our test. As soon as test completes, it came to again 0%. That means there is no activity in the GC, everything got released. Okay, so likewise we should see. And also this GC should not increase this heap memory. Some reason it is keep on going, it should come down actually. So there is some application, object still running, they are not getting garbage collected. Let's do some perform GC. See, as soon as I perform GC, it came to zero. Okay, so now whatever objects were there, it got removed everything. Okay, after test there was still some objects were running background. Whenever I perform GC, everything cleared and it came to 0%. From here onwards, it will be using little bit garbage collection and heap memory, because some objects will be creating, right? Whenever this application is running, few objects will be running in background. For that, it needs little bit of GC memory. Okay, so this way, if you see like linear increase, that means your application is not good. Always, as soon as test completes, it should go down. Okay, linearly it should come down. Okay, so this is all about our application. See, even you see thread count got increased like anything after 25 users and it came down. Okay, so this is the way we should monitor the heap memory and thread memory, thread utilization, and what is classes loading. So if you someone asks you in interview, you can say that these are the hidden spaces we have, how many generations you have in heap memory, and what kind of they will ask you what is thread usage, what kind of states you have in thread dumps, and if you see heap dumps, what kind of generations you have, and what is permanent generation, metaspace. Metaspace will be used for to store classes, to load classes and methods. what are the GC algorithms. These are the GC algorithms, serial, parallel GC, CMS, G1, and what are the default GCs, and process level also, you can see process CPU also, okay. So this way we should monitor our application and we should report them, okay. So that's all. Hopes this helps you a lot in our interviews. So if you have any questions regarding this, you can let me know. In next video I will show you JVisual VM, how to monitor through another tool, JVisual VM. This is the tool we can monitor. Here the advantage of Visual VM is it is kind of profiling tool where you can take thread dumps and heap dumps, and we can do more things. Next time whenever I do video, I will show you same application. We can take some thread dumps and heap dumps and we will analyze them, how it goes, okay. So this is my application, right? So you click this one and it will come up here with same way. However, you see here the same way it looks here as well, okay. So here it will show you JVM arguments, system properties, and monitor. Under monitor it will show you process level, heap level, and meta space, and how many classes, how many live threads. And if you want to see only thread level, you can see here. Here the only advantage we have is thread dump, and even we have heap dumps also. This we will see later upcoming videos, how to take head thread dumps, what are the important things we should look there, and also we can see this one as well, how to check thread dumps and what thread dumps gives. Some interview they may ask you how thread dumps looks, what important things you will check in thread dumps. Also the only thing you can see is same thing whatever I mentioned here, right? How many runnable threads, how many timed waiting. You should not see more blocked. If you see more blocked, you should inform your stakeholders saying we have seen more blocked threads and we have seen more waiting threads. Then they have to dig why they are taking more waiting state, okay. It will give more details why it is waiting, what object it is waiting for. This we will see in next video, okay. So once again thanks for watching, okay. See you next session. If you need any details, I am going to give you my contact details in my description, so you can contact me there, WhatsApp number and my email address. If you have any concerns, you need any guidelines or anything, you can reach me there. Thank you guys, thanks for watching. Please do subscribe, do let other know. Thank you. See you in next session. Bye for now.